respected Dr. H.S. Ballal, Pro Chancellor of Manipal Academy of Higher Education, Dr. Annapurna, Head of the Division of Yoga of Mahe Manipal, and all the participants from constituent institutions of Manipal Academy of Higher Education, I wholeheartedly welcome all of you for this particular 21st June 20th, 2020 for celebrating International Yoga Day in Mahe Manipal. Since inception in the year 2015, June 21st, we celebrated International Yoga Day in Mahe Manipal. This was the brainchild of our Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi. And this year also, successfully, we have initiated this particular event in Manipal Academy of Higher Education. And a lot of students, faculty from various institutions have come forward to participate in this event. We welcome Dr. H.S. Ballal, Pro Chancellor of Manipal Academy of Higher Education, as chief guest, and request him to inaugurate this particular event. I congratulate and compliment Dr. Annapurna and our colleagues of Manipal Academy of Higher Education in the Yoga Division, who initiated this particular event. Once again, I welcome all of you for this particular inaugural program of today's International Yoga Day in Mahe Manipal. Thank you.
Since its inception in the year 2015, June 21st is celebrated as the International Day of Yoga all over the world. As a matter of fact, this was the brainchild of our beloved Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Modi. Yoga is an invaluable gift from our ancient tradition. Yoga embodies unity of mind and body, thought and action, a holistic approach that is valuable to our health and our well-being. Yoga is not just about exercise, it's a way to discover the sense of oneness with yourself, the world and the nature. While the social distancing measures adopted by countries to fight the COVID-19 pandemic, yoga is a very powerful tool to deal with the stress of uncertainty and isolation, as well as to maintain physical well-being. The World Health Organization mentions yoga as a means to improve health in its more active people for a healthier world. Yoga is an ancient physical, mental, and spiritual practice which gives calmness, peace, confidence, and courage to the people through which they can do several activities in a much better way. At every level of existence, it is a state of harmony. I am extremely happy to inaugurate International Yoga Day of Mahe today. I am happy to know that in spite of COVID-19 problems throughout the world, the Yoga Division of Center of Integrative Medicine and Research, CIMR, is organizing this event with great enthusiasm. Mahe management appreciates the great efforts of faculty, staff, and the students of Yoga Division with the support of all the institutions of our campus. I thank the organizing committee of the event for giving me an opportunity to be part of this inaugural event and share a few of my thoughts with you. I wish all the best to participants and the organizing committee members. Thank you.
Greetings from Manipal Academy of Higher Education, the Center for Integrative Medicine and Research. On this International Day of Yoga 2020, with the message Yoga from Home, Yoga with Family, we would like to say that taking 15 to 20 minutes of time daily to practice yoga will help you a lot in this stressful situation where you are socially isolated due to the coronavirus pandemic. Our team has put together a short video of various asanas you can try in the confines of your home to give you freedom from the stress and anxiety you are facing in these difficult times. With this message, please stay home, stay safe, practice yoga for a healthy mind and healthy body. Thank you.
योगस्थः कुरु कर्माणि संगम त्यक्त्वा धनंजय सिद्धि असिद्धिः समो भूत्वा समत्वं योग उच्यते। नमस्ते। I cordially invite all the viewers to this awareness program on yoga. Within a period of few months, all of us have been affected directly or indirectly. That brought out the fears in each one of us. We know that our thoughts and our emotions can affect our immunity system. The negative thoughts, fears, emotions, stress, sympathetic arousal will weaken our immunity system. When immunity system is weakened, there will be infections, inflammations, degenerations, and also autoimmune disorders. While practice of yoga will improve immunity with positive emotions and relaxation, strengthens the immunity. Yoga practices will strengthen our immune system by inducing a sense of confidence from within us. Systematic practice of asana, physical postures, pranayama, breathing techniques, dhyana, meditation techniques, shavasanas, relaxation techniques, they help us to regain control over the senses and emotions. Yoga is a process to transform our negative thoughts into positive thoughts, resulting in relaxation response. Yoga has been practiced since centuries in keeping the body and mind healthy, as well as for a better lifestyle practice. However, the benefits of yoga are not just limited to the stress release or mental wellness. The practice of yoga also helps to boost our immune system by reducing inflammation, infection, and degeneration. Also improves respiratory physiology by improving lung volumes, lung capacities, and also improve digestive physiology by improving digestive secretions and improving peristalsis. Also improves nerve physiology by promoting neural conductivity and balancing autonomic nervous system functions. And also yoga practice improves cardiac efficiency by improving peripheral circulation. Now, with all these introduction, let us focus on specific yoga techniques or yoga practices. First, the practices are purificatory procedures called as Shat Kriyas. Especially Kapalabhati Kriya and Jalaneti Kriya, due to the pressure variation mechanism, they purify excess mucus secretions and excess kapha molecules from the sinuses of the skull, nasal passage and respiratory passage. They also stimulates the nerve endings of sinuses, respiratory passage and nasal passage, and prevent from further accumulation of kapha molecules and mucus secretions. They are useful to enhance protective reflexes of respiratory system and to promote healthy respiratory functions. Next, principles of yoga practices are practices of yama niyama or cleanliness, purity, or self and social hygiene practices. They are very important in the present moment, where physical distancing and personal hygiene are being practiced by all of us. So yama niyama practices are very important, and should be practiced by all of us. Then, the practices of asanas or physical postures. By the practice of various asana techniques, they rebalance all the systems of the body. A group of chest expansion postures remove the congestion of respiratory system, particularly from the respiratory passage, and promotes easy breathing. A group of forward bending asanas, they strengthen the respiratory muscles and they improve the digestive secretions. A group of inverted postures, they relax the respiratory system and promote relaxed breathing. So the set of asanas are Gomukhasana, Urdhva Vajrasana, Parshvottanasana, Bhujangasana, Shalabhasana. Forward bending asanas are Paschimottanasana, Marichasana, Janushirshasana. And inverted postures are Padottanasana and Sarvangasana. Practice of pranayamas. So, pranayama practice is enhancing the prana or vitality or immunity by regulating the process of inspiration and expiration. Systematic breathing techniques will do the temperature regulation and they improve the breathing pattern and they slow down the breath rate and normalize heart rate and blood pressure. The slow and deep breathing techniques, also called as diaphragmatic breathing, strengthens the digestive system also with respiratory system. As an example, the benefits of Surya Bedana Pranayama has been explained in the Hatha Yoga textbooks as Kapala Shodhanam, Vataharam, Krimi Doshagnam, Punaha Punaha Idam Kuryat, Surya Bhedanam Uttamam. The practice of Surya Nadi breathing or pranayama will purify all the sinuses of the skull and nasal passage, Vataharam. It promotes temperature regulation. So, it reduces inflammation and degeneration. Krimi Doshagnam, it prevents from the infection and make the breathing easy and improves the respiration. So, present situation or moment, Surya Bedana practice pranayama is very important to prevent from the infection and to improve the respiration. Next, the meditation practices or dhyana practices. The subtle dhyana practices and gross dhyana practices will improve cell metabolism and also strengthen the body defense mechanism by changing gene expression of certain immune cells. Also controls the release of stress hormones. So, dhyana should be practiced for stress management. And the practice of shavasanas or relaxation techniques will relax the body and mind, induces the relaxation response and result in deep rest and induce sleep. Shavasanam Shrantiharam Chitta Vishranti Karanam. A 45 minutes to 1 hour regular practice of yoga will sustain the physiology into parasympathetic dominance, as all the yoga techniques are parasympathetic in nature. With all this introduction about yoga and improving immunity and preventing infections, now the demonstration session for the daily regular practice to prevent the respiratory infections and for stress management and to improve the immunity. Now the demonstration session. First practice is purificatory procedure, Kapala Bhati Kriya. Sit in Samasthiti, perform Padmasana, assume Chin Mudra. Forcible inhalations and exhalations should be practiced. According to one's capacity, like this, one can practice 3 to 5 rounds for the purification of sinuses, nasal passage, and respiratory passage. Come back to Samasthiti and relax. The practice of Surya Namaskara, stand in Samasthiti. This practice is also called as Vaidika Surya Namaskara, practiced according to the Vedic informations. Surya Namaskara will coordinate all the systems in the body and relaxes the mind. So let us start with Surya Namaskara practice. Breathing in, lift your hands above the head, join them and look at your hands. Step 2, breathing out, slowly bend forward. Bend your head towards the knees. Step 3, breathing in, look front. Step 4, breathing out, jump backward and lie down on the ground. Step 5, breathing in, move your body front, look up. Step 6, breathing out, stand on the feet and palms. Look at the navel region and slowly breathe for 5 times. Step 7, breathing in, put your legs between the palms and look front. 8, breathing out, bend your head towards the knees. 9, breathing in, lift your hands, join them above the head and look at the hands. Now breathing out, bring down the hands, stand in Samasthiti, look front and breathe normally. This Surya Namaskara practice should be practiced 3 to 5 times daily. Now practice of group of asanas. First one is Svastikasana. Sit in Samasthiti, breathe in, while breathing out, bend your left leg inside, breathe in, while breathing out, bend your right leg inside, put it on the left leg, assume Chin Mudra, back, neck straight, close your eyes, breathe normally for 10 times. Open your eyes, breathing in, stretch your right leg, breathe out, breathing in, stretch your left leg, breathe out, sit in Samasthiti. Next practice is Vajrasana. Sit in Samasthiti, breathe in, while breathing out, bend your legs back, sit on the heels, place your palms on the knees, back and neck straight. Look front and breathe normally. After 5 breathings, next one is Supta Vajrasana. Breathing out, hold your toes by hands. Now breathe in. While breathing out, slowly bend forward. Touch your forehead to the ground, eyes closed. Breathe normally for 5 times. Now breathing in, slowly come up. Breathe out, release your hands, place them on the knees. Next one is Urdhva Vajrasana. Interlock the fingers. Breathing in, stretch your hands above the head. Look at the hands and breathe slowly for 5 times. Breathing out, put your hands down, place on the knees. Breathing in, stretch your legs, sit in Samasthiti. Relax. Practice of Swastikasana and set of Vajrasanas will improve stability of the body and mind and improve the respiratory physiology and digestive physiology. All the asanas are practiced with steps, breathing patterns and vision, and also one has to maintain the asana sthiti for minimum 5 breathing to get complete benefits of the asanas. Next one is Parivrata Tadasana. Standing posture. Stand in Samasthiti. Interlock the fingers. Breathing in, stretch your hands above the head. Breathing out, turn back from right side above the waist region. Look at the hands and breathe slowly. Breathing in, turn to front. Breathing out, turn back from left side. Look at the hands and breathe slowly. Breathing in, turn to front. Breathing out, put your hands down. Release your fingers and stand in Samasthiti. Next one is Trikonasana. Stand in Samasthiti. Breathing in, place your right leg to right side. One leg distance, stretch your hands. Now breathing out, turn your right foot to right. Slowly go on bending. Hold the right toe by right hand. Stretch your left hand straight. Look at the left hand and breathe slowly. Breathing in, slowly come up. Turn your right foot to front. Now left foot to left side. Breathing out, go on bending. Hold the left toe by left hand. Look at the right hand, which is straight up, and breathe slowly. Breathing in, slowly come up. Turn your left foot to front. Breathing out, join your right leg to left. Release the hand, stand in Samasthiti. Next asana is Parshvottanasana. Stand in Samasthiti. Join your palms at your back. Now breathing in, place your right leg to right side at 1 foot distance. Breathing out, turn your right foot to right side. Turn your body to right side. Go on bending towards the right knee. close your eyes, breathe normally. Breathing in slowly, come up, turn to front. Now breathing out, turn to left side. Go on bending towards the left knee. Bend your head towards the knees, eyes closed. Breathe slowly. Breathing in slowly, come up, turn to front. Breathing out, release your hands, join your right leg to left to form Samasthiti. Parivritta Tadasana, Trikonasana and Parshvottanasana. In their asana sthiti, they expand the chest, so they remove the congestion of the respiratory passage and they improve the lung functions and easy the breathing. Next, sitting postures. Sit in Samasthiti, Paschimottanasana. Breathing in, lift your hands and join them above the head and look at the hands. Breathing out, slowly bend forward. Hold the toes by respective hands. Forehead on the knees, close your eyes and breathe slowly. Breathing in, release the hands, join them above the head, look at the hands. Breathing out, put your hands down, sit in Samasthiti. Next, Purvottanasana. Breathe in, place your hands back, breathe out. Breathing in, lift your body up, stretch your toes towards the ground, look back and breathe slowly. Breathing out, slowly come down, place your hands side of the body. Sit in Samasthiti. Next practice is Janushirshasana. Breathe in. While breathing out, bend your left leg. Place the foot at the root of the right thigh. Stretch it about 120 degrees. Breathe in. While breathing out, bend forward. Hold the toes by both hands. Bend your head to the knee. Slowly breathe. Now breathing in, slowly come up. Release your hands. Breathing out, stretch your hands. Breathing in, stretch your leg. Now breathing out, bend your right leg about 120 degrees. Breathe in. Breathing out, bend forward. Hold the left toe by both hands. Head should touch the knee. Close your eyes and slow breathing. Breathing in, slowly come up, release the hand, breathe out. Breathing in, stretch your right leg, sit in Samasthiti. Next one is Vakrasana. Breathing in, bend your right leg, knee facing up. Breathing out, put it on left side. Now cover the right knee with left hand. Breathing out, turn to back from right side. Look at your back, breathe slowly. Breathing in, turn to front. Breathe out, release your hands. Breathing in, place your right leg on right side. Breathing out, release the right leg. Now breathing in, bend your left leg, knee facing up. Breathing out, put it on right side. Now cover the left knee by right hand, hold the toe. Breathing out, look back from left side. Breathe slowly for 5 times. Breathing in, turn to front. Breathe out, release your hands. Breathing in, place your left leg on left side. Breathing out, release the left leg and sit in Samasthiti. Now lying down asanas, Pavana Muktasana. Lie down in Samasthiti and breathe normally. Breathe in, breathing out, bend your both legs on the chest, hold them by both hands. Breathing in, lift your head, touch the forehead to the knees, eyes closed and breathe normally. Breathing out, put your head down. Breathing in, stretch your legs, relax. Now lie down on your stomach, Makarasana. Makarasana is a relaxation asana. Also, it improves digestion. One has to breathe for 10 times. Next one is Bhujangasana, Samasthiti. Place your hands below the shoulders. Breathing in, slowly lift your face, chest up, up to the stomach. Look straight up and breathe slowly. Breathing out, slowly come down. Lie down in Samasthiti. Next is Shalabhasana, hands below the thighs. Breathing in, lift your legs, face, chest up. Look up and breathe slowly. Breathing out, slowly come down. Release your hands, lie down in Samasthiti. Next is Dhanurasana. Breathe in. Bend your legs, hold them by both hands. Now breathing in, slowly come up. Try to look up and breathe slowly. Breathing out, slowly come down. Release your legs. Lie down in Samasthiti. Next one is Padottanasana. Lie down in Samasthiti. Join your legs. Place your hands both sides at shoulder level. Breathing in, lift your both legs straight up. Relax the shoulders. Look at the legs and breathe slowly. breathing out slowly, come down. Lie down in Samasthiti. All these group of asanas will remove the congestion of the respiratory system, improve the digestive juices, and relaxes the mind and coordinates all the systems in the body. Now, practice of pranayama or breathing techniques. First one is Nadi Shodhana Pranayama. The pranayama for the purification of nadis, also to improve respiratory physiology. Sit in Samasthiti. Assume Padmasana or any easy sitting postures can be performed here for pranayama practice. Hold Mrigiya Mudra in right hand, Chin Mudra in left hand. Close your right nostril. Breathe in through the left nose. Close it. Perform Jalandhara Bandha. Hold the breath for 10 counts. Release the bandha. Breathe out through right nostril. Now breathe in through the right nostril slowly. Perform Jalandhara Bandha. Hold the breath for 10 counts. Release the Jalandhara Bandha. Breathe out through left nostril. Release your hand. Sit in Samasthiti. This is one round of Nadi Shodhana Pranayama with Kumbhaka or retention of breath. For the regular practice, it should be practiced for 21 rounds. Next one is Surya Bedhana Pranayama. Sit in Padmasana. Hold Mrigiya Mudra and Chin Mudra. Close your left nose. Breathe in through the right nose slowly. Apply Jalandhara Bandha. Retain your breath for 10 counts. Release the Jalandhara Bandha. Breathe out slowly through the left nostril. Release your hands. Sit in Samasthiti. Surya Bedhana Pranayama should be practiced regularly for 21 times. Next pranayama is Bhastrika Pranayama. Sit in Padmasana. Hold the Chin Mudra. Breathe in and breathe out rapidly with sound as much as possible according to the capacity. Now breathe in through the right nose, perform Jalandhara Bandha, hold the breath for 10 counts. Now release the Jalandhara Bandha, breathe out through the left nostril slowly. Sit in Samasthiti. Next one is Bhramari Pranayama. Sit in Padmasana. In this practice, during inhalation, one has to produce male B sound. Then one has to perform Kumbhaka. And while exhalation, one has to produce female B sound. नाडी शोधन प्राणायाम सूर्य भेदन प्राणायाम भस्त्रिका एंड भ्रामरी प्राणायामास आर प्रैक्टिस्ड विद कुंभका अकॉर्डिंग टू द कैपेसिटी इफ वन इज नॉट एबल टू होल्ड द ब्रेथ और परफॉर्म द कुंभका दे कैन डू ओनली पूरक एंड रेचक और इनहलेशन एंड एक्सहलेशंस विद ऑल दीज प्राणायामास ऑल दीज प्राणायामास improve respiratory physiology when mentally involved in the kumbhaka phase it also improves nerve physiology so practice of pranayama will improve prana functions or improve physiology of all the systems in the body next practice of relaxation techniques or shavasanas pranaanusandhana shavasana lie down in samasthiti legs apart left hand on the chest right palm on the stomach shoulders relaxed close your eyes and breathe normally while breathing observe your breathing movements through the palms and focus on it practice of pranaanusandhana shavasana reduces breath rate normalizes heart rate and blood pressure all the body muscles and joints are relaxed simultaneously improves peripheral circulation new thoughts in the mind are not formed one will get mental calmness and the whole body and mind are relaxed which will induce deep rest and sleep one has to practice this for 5 to 10 minutes now put your hands down Close your eyes and breathe slowly. Practice is dhyana practice or meditation technique. Soham meditation. Sit in swastikasana. Hold chin mudra, back, neck, head straight. Close your eyes. While breathing in, mentally pronounce swaha or so. While breathing out, mentally pronounce aham or hum. Inhaling, so. Exhaling, hum. Soham meditation. One has to practice this for 10 to 20 minutes. Continuously observe and produce so hum mentally and involve with the so hum word. When the aspirant will completely become one with the objective thought or soham, there will be complete awareness of the mental thought soham, merging ourselves with the universal self. Saha is universal self, aham is myself. So union with myself, with the universal self. Practice of meditation relaxes the mind, promotes the cell metabolism, reduces the release of stress hormones, and improves immunity. There are various techniques of gross and subtle meditation. Soham meditation is the basic practice of meditation, can be practiced by all the age groups. All these yoga techniques are from the tradition of Ashtanga Vinyasa Yoga, a systematic practice of yoga techniques to attain Chitta Vritti Nirodha or to induce relaxation response. To prevent from infections, one has to practice these techniques regularly, can be practiced by all the age group. Patients who are suffering from COVID-19, after they become stable, they have to only practice pranayama, meditations and shavasanas or relaxation techniques. Then slowly they can practice all these yoga techniques one by one. To prevent from further infections and to promote further immunity, I would quote a shloka from Bhagavad Gita: Yukta ahara viharasya, yukta chestasya karmasu, yukta swapna avabhodasya yogo bhavati dukkaha. All these yoga techniques should be practiced regularly with a balanced diet pattern and with a balanced sleep pattern. Then only one will get complete benefit of their regular practice. With this conclusion, once again I convey my best wishes to all the viewers, and also I give thanks to all the supporters of this program. Thank you. Namaste.